and welcome back to the video series dedicated to the only show giving you the Pride Parade through the perspective of one specific restaurant in California. That's right, I'm talking about Bravo's original series, Vanderpump Rules, Season 7, Episode 2. Episode 1 left off with Jax proposing to Brittany at a seafood restaurant, and Brittany said yes! And now Episode 2 takes place right after that. As they are driving back to their apartment, there's a surprise engagement party put up by our own Stassi. Yes, Stassi had the biggest like job that she had to do by getting balloons, make sure Hooters sauce is not all over the floor, making sure everybody's on the same page with all their social media, and corralling the Toms to actually make drinks together. Lisa, you can get a note out of Stassi's book. Well, it's a huge surprise to Brittany as Jax and Brittany come up. Everybody says surprise. Everybody's having a great time. Even Lisa shows up. And it's really weird because I've been watching this show for years. And when everybody gets together, it's not as good of a time. Some drama always comes up, but not this time. And I wonder what's different. That's right. James is not here. He is back at Sur, at Sur's Day or whatever, doing his DJ thing, lighting it up. He didn't even know a party was happening until Billy Lee came over from our hosting post and was like, hey, Jax just proposed to Brittany. Look at the Instagram post. And James, of course, had to ruin the moment by going into his confessional and like saying that Jax is the devil or something. Why can't you just be happy for him and say congratulations? Like, seriously? So fast forward to the end of the night where Jax was like, y'all can stay if you want, but me and Brittany are going to go upstairs and consummate the engagement, which repulsed everybody, and everybody hit the exit with lightning speed. Good job, Jax. Now fast forward to the next day. Everybody's getting excited for the Pride Day at Sur and Pump. It's 80s themed, so everybody's at this like designer, like costume party store kind of thing. And, the Tom, Ariana, Sheena, and LaLa all are together, getting all their fitting, like bright colored, like spandex shorts and whatnot. And Tom's doing his like aerobics, like pelvic thrust, which, hey, he's doing a great job with it. He has good form. LaLa is telling everybody, announcing to everybody, that she is not messing around with James this season. Apparently, at Coachella, her and her man were caught off guard by some of James's comments. At one point he goes, oh come on guys, we all know each other inside and out if you know what I mean. Why? That was Australian, but don't knock me out for that. So Tom and Ariana were like, whoa, we might bring this up to him when we are having our double date, like apartment party, dinner party later. They don't bring it up. They're having a great time. And you know what? Can I just say, I appreciate Tom and Ariana in this kind of show and setting because they just get along with everybody. It's really nice to see, like, with over the years, there's been so many cracks, divots, switch up with groups and cliques and stuff. And Tom and Ariana are just like, why can't we all just talk together and not have drama every minute of every day? So they get to go hang out with James and Raquel. Everybody seems to be chill and cool and relaxed and everything, and they're just really excited to be at Sur the next day for Pride and whatnot. While all that is going on, Kristen and Stassi are getting all together. Kristen is saying like she has this maniacal plan of exposing James for the cheating rat, dirty weasel that he is, which I don't think you need to like expose him. I feel like we all pretty much know what his MO is. But she says that this other girl, Hope, that she's been friends with for like 4 years, has been hooking up with James on and off for like years now, while Raquel and James have been together. And apparently this Hope and Raquel are supposed to be friends, so that's not very friendly. But she's being very friendly to James. And Stassi was like, I don't need this drama. I'm gonna walk away and you can do whatever you want to. And Kristen has like this maniacal look in her face. Fast forward a little bit more. Jax actually goes over to Lisa Vanderpump's house in his cool red Corvette Stingray that his dad left for him. He goes into a little bit of his family history, that's recent family history, and he says that he used a lot of the inheritances his dad left when he passed to buy Brittany's engagement ring, so he needs a little bit more money coming in with the inflow. So he asks Lisa if he could possibly have his bartending job at Sur back. Which Lisa's like, is that really good because of your history and all the stuff that you have, especially with James and the recent thing that happened in the first episode when he went and reprimanded James inside Sur? And Jax has said, like, I'm changed. It's the same song and dance. He says that he's changed, because of his dad's passing and whatnot. And realistically, he hasn't done anything to say that he hasn't changed. He hasn't shown that he hasn't changed, and his mindset hasn't changed. He looks like he's been changed for the better, but is it a quick change or a long-term change? That's what's on Lisa's mind, and she goes, well, you can work Pride Day at Sur in the Garden Bar on a trial basis, and I think that's the best option to do for this situation. So now, it's Pride Day, everybody's dressed up, it's like Christmas for Sur and Pump. Like, there's so many people that come out, walking the streets, doing their thing, dressing how they want to dress, doing what they want to do, drinking how much ever they want to drink, as we can see by James and his, throughout his whole DJ thing, in this day alone. Like, it looked like he had like 18 drinks back there, which I thought he wasn't allowed to drink while DJing. Well, the whole day is going through. Everybody's having a good time doing his thing. Jax is actually knocking off some of the rust, even with how busy he was getting. Tom was right there next to him, helping him out, doing his thing and whatnot. And then Kristen shows up, and she shows up with Hope, and I guess they went through the back, and they were trying to, like, ambush James while he was DJing or when he gets off on a break, but they ran into Raquel first and decided to corner her when she was looking for the bathroom and was like, yo, you know, for years, James has been, like, seriously cheating on you and all this other stuff. And Raquel instantly gets defensive, as she probably should be, as these two girls are telling her, and, like, we've known for years, we've been doing this for years, and Raquel's like, yo, you've been, like, nuts over James for the longest time. And not gonna lie, I can see where she's coming from. Kristen, if Kristen was more of a friend to Raquel, instead of being more of an angry ex that she's shown from in the past couple of seasons to James, maybe she would be believed a little bit more. But this whole news hits Raquel with a ton of bricks, and she goes, I need to go find James right away. Where James is over there giving his tequila gift basket to Brittany and Jax as a congratulatory engagement, and I'm so sorry for saying that white Kanye stuff. And Raquel comes over and is like, yo, did you cheat on me and all this other stuff? Hope is doing this, Kristen's doing this. Where James is visibly angry, like 0 to 100, he is fuming. Flames are coming out of his ears, smoke is coming out of his nostrils, and Jax just has this face behind him like, yeah, I remember these days. And even in his confessional, he's like, yo, I remember when people were coming at me about me cheating, and I always denied till I died, and it all came out that it was all true. So, James, maybe you should come clean if it is true instead of denied till you die. James gets furious. I mean, this is the whole rest of the episode is people ganging up on him. He goes to talk to LaLa, where he is like, I thought we were bros, I thought we were cool, and now you're just like turning your back on me and acting all like the others when I had your back when nobody else did. And then he's getting like, Ariana's coming after him and all this other stuff. And finally Katie makes a comment, and then he tries to body shame Katie at the last couple of episodes while he's smoking a cigarette. Can I just say, you know how disgusting you look with how much knowledge we have about smoking these days and how young you are to, like, to be still smoking and then to be criticizing somebody else's body, which she doesn't even look that bad. Like, she said earlier, she's like, I feel comfortable in my body. I'm not gonna be the same size as Ariana. I'm not gonna be the same size as LaLa, but I look good, I feel good, and I feel the best I've ever felt. You know what, that's all you need? And guess what? She doesn't look half bad. So, can I just say, like, don't look at other people and be like, yo, you need to lose weight because you're, like, a little porkier than normal. Like, you have a cigarette in your hand, bro. You are a twig that has so much hair gel in his hair and then smoking a cigarette. You look so bad. You look the worst, and you're yelling. You're drunk as all get out. You're walking down the street, taking pictures with any random chick because you're yelling you're a DJ. Get off of it, man. Well, that's how this episode ends. It only looks like it's going to ramp up the drama from here on out for the rest of the season. But what do you think about this episode? Leave me in the comment section, comment in the comment section below. And while you're down there, hit that like. If you're new to the channel, hit that subscribe button to hear me talk about Vanderpump every week. and some of my other stuff that I'm going to be doing. Thank you so much for watching. Were you excited about hearing all about James this episode, or are you kind of over it? Or were you just excited that there's so much drama and this whole show is all about drama? Let me know in the comment section below, but thank you for watching, and I'll be back on Monday with the episode, because Vanderpump next week is out on Sunday, a special night. So look for this episode, another Vanderpump episode, to come out on Monday, but I'll see y'all next week. Peace!